Brook the owl, Brook the owl shy, Brook the owl, Brook the owl shy, Brook the owl, Brook the owl shy. Oh, praise unto Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, Wahara Kakadash, double honors unto the apostles, a great millstone. Honestly, brothers will be pushing this truth in sincerity throughout the four corners of the earth. So this is gonna be a video going into the chariots, okay, what you know as the UFOs, and what we know as the chariots of the Lord. And pretty much this article, I'm not gonna get into the article too much. You can read the article for yourself on RT. But you always hear this thing of whether there's life on other planets, and whether you know, you're gonna see life forms coming into the earth. And really, what they're not telling you about is the information that's contained within the scriptures, okay, regarding the chariots, regarding the salvation of the 12 tribes of Israel, okay. Because when you go into the scriptures, you're talking about you're talking about when the Lord was taken up into the skies. Well, pretty much that was a chariot that did that. Well, you know, as a so-called abduction, okay. What this world will have you believe is an abduction, but really he was going into the what? Into the spiritual realm, okay. So let's start here within the book of Zechariah, the 5th chapter, on the 1st verse. It says, "Then I turned and looked." Rather more, then I turned and lifted up my eyes and looked, and behold, a flying roll. Okay, and he said unto me, "What seest thou?" So this is the man Zechariah, okay, and I believe it's an angel he's speaking to here, and the angel said to him, you know, what you're seeing, you know, what's going on there, and he's writing it down, he's writing a countdown of what happened, and he said unto me, "What seest thou?" And I answered, "I see a flying roll, and the length thereof 20 cubits. And the breadth thereof 10 cubits. Then said he unto me, "This is the curse that goeth forth the whole earth, for everyone that stealeth shall be cut off on the side according to it, and everyone that sweareth shall be cut off on the side according to it." Because when we're dealing with a thing of salvation, I need the Apocrypha for this one. Okay, when we're dealing with a thing of the chariots, okay, we're dealing with also, you know, salvation as well as, okay, destruction. Okay, when you're talking about the chariots coming back to take the 12 tribes of Israel, okay, you're also talking about the destruction of Esau's empire by way of the chariots, okay, the so-called UFOs, okay. So let's start here within the book of, let's go into this one, within the Apocrypha, in the book of Wisdom of Solomon, the 5th chapter and the 1st verse. And this goes into it beautifully, okay? This is the book of Wisdom of Solomon, the 5th chapter and the 1st verse. It says, "Then shall the righteous man stand in great, then shall the righteous, then the righteous," let's see, I knew that weren't reading right. You know, when you taste a drink, you're like something funky about that drink. Okay, this is back within this. Now this is the King James version. It says, "Then shall the righteous man stand in great boldness before the face of such as afflicted him, and made no account of his labors. And when they shall see it, when they shall see what these so-called UFOs that they're seeing, and you know, they're saying what, you know, angels, or what are they saying? They're saying some chariot out there is basically I'll try to pull up the page again. But they'll make it sound like anything, you know, other than what it is. Study reveals reason aliens may be snatching stars and caging them into megastructures. I mean, who knows what the actual, you know, Lord is doing. The scripture talks about how his ways are way beyond ours. But the fact of the matter is, it ain't no green, you know, little green people out there. But rather the chariots and the angels of the Lord. And the scriptures does say that the Lord was going to go out there and prepare a world for us. Okay, but that's for the 12 tribes of Israel. Okay, for the rest of the heathens, they're going to be enslaved. We might send them slaves out there. I'm not saying we're going to do this. I'm not putting it out there as doctrine. But it's a possibility. We might send certain chariots out there into the skies to mine certain planets for resource. But you're going to find life there? No, we're going to send the life out there to inhabit Earth. to bring back, the goodies. Just a theory, just an idea. And I'm not saying that's exactly what's going to happen. But what we do know within the scriptures is that the Lord said that in his house, in his father's house, there are many mansions, alluding to the fact that what? Here is where life is at. Okay, the center of the universe, as it will, if you will, and we're gonna fill up the universe. Okay, pretty much. So it says that then shall the righteous man stand in great boldness. Stand in great boldness before the in the presence of those that oppress them. See, you can always tell when it's the wrong version. I don't know why it did that. Okay, this is supposed to be the King James version. It's not really reading right. Anyways, it says, "Then shall the right." Now I'll read it from memory. It should say, "Then shall the righteous man stand in great boldness before the face of him, such as made that afflicted him, and made no account of his labors. And when they shall see it, they shall be troubled with terrible fear." Okay, at the strangeness of their salvation. It says unexpectedness, which okay, that could be you could put that in there because the scriptures does talk about the day of the Lord is gonna come as a thief in the night, but also too, I prefer the strangeness because them UFOs are strange unto these people. Okay, it's out there. Okay, so I'm gonna get one more precept, and this was dealing with Yahushua when he left. I believe it's within the book of Acts, might be even the first chapter, or is it the fifth chapter? Okay, that was Acts 1 and 5. Just bear with me. Okay, so Acts, the first chapter, and then I'll go to the ninth verse. Okay, it says, "And when he had spoken these things, while they yet behold, he was taken up, and the cloud received him out of his sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward the heavens, okay, he went up, and behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, Ye men of Galilee, why ye stand ye up gazing?" Okay, this same Yahushua, or Jesus, forbade him, okay, "which is taken up from you, is taken into the heavens, and so shall come in like manner, okay, as ye have seen, okay, go into, as ye seen him going unto the heavens." So when he comes back with that fathership, as illustrated within the book of Zechariah, the 13th chapter, okay, that's how he's going to come back. So this talk of angels, and that's what they're saying, aliens, and those are really angels. Okay, God knows what they're doing out there. When you look at the through the telescope, that's too that's beyond our realm. We're supposed to be dealing with the things down here, okay? But pretty much, that's how he's gonna come back. He's gonna come back, with the chariots in it. Okay, so pretty much with that, I'm gonna say, "Oh, praise unto Yahweh." Double honors unto the apostles of great millstone. Once your brothers will be pushing the truth in sincerity. Shalom.